As we continue to compose different graphics, we may find that we reach the point that we want to combine vector images with raster images. So vector, which we usually create in Illustrator, and then raster or bitmap that we usually work with in Photoshop. Photoshop does have some vector tools, but they're really pretty basic. And so what we end up doing is we reach the point that we want to combine graphics from these two programs together. So I'm going to walk you through a really quick demo on that. We're going to create something similar to this right here. So I just put this together a few minutes ago. And so I came up with a photograph of mountains and a silhouette with the sunset back there. And I decided I wanted to do this rocket taking off. But I was going to go with vector artwork for the rocket. So I've gone and created some various pieces here in Illustrator. But first we're going to start with this image right here, the Blake Richard image. And that is this sunset image we have in the background here. So the first thing I need to do is I need to put a mask on my mountains here, because some of this is coming from behind the mountains, and this is obviously one image right now. So I need to separate the sky from the mountains. So I'm going to go over to my layers. I have the background here, and I need to duplicate that, and I'm just going to grab that and drag it down here on my new layers icon, and that gives me a duplicate. I'm going to rename this and just call it mountains, because it's not going to have the sky anymore. And I just want to go create the mask. Now this one's pretty simple because it's a silhouette. I'm just going to come up here and I'm going to grab my quick selection tool up here, and I'm going to come down. Let's enlarge that brush a little bit. And wow, that was really quick. There's my mountains. And it was very easy to select because they're just black. Let's go clean up the edge just a little bit. I'm going to come back over to layers, come down to the bottom, and find the icon here for add layer mask. I'm going to click on that. So it created my layer mask. You can't really tell because I have the one behind it still. So this is the complete one. And this one, you see my mask. What is in white is what shows. So only the mountains are showing. I've masked out the sky. And you can tell when I hide that background image, you see there's nothing back there now. Okay, so let's see. With this one, I want to go to properties, and let's go to select and mask, and I'm just going to turn edge detection on just a little bit, just so that it cleans up that edge a little bit, but it's really a simple image that way. So I'm going to turn it on just a little bit and say okay. There we go. Now I have my two different layers. Actually, I have three layers now. I created a copy of that. So there is my mountains right there. Here's my background. I can turn my background back on. Okay, let's go save real quick. Let's do a save as, and I'm going to save on my computer, and let's call it Rocket Blast Off, and that's a .psd, and let's see, I don't have anything named exactly like that, so I'm going to just save that in my folder. Maximize compatibility, that's a good idea. Okay, now let's jump back out here to the Finder. Here's the images. I want to show you the various pieces I created in Illustrator. They're pretty straightforward. First, there's one that's called Clouds, so I'm going to open clouds.ai. And I'm going to turn off the preview by doing Command Y. And you'll see that this really is just a series of circles. Okay, so I have a batch of white circles and a batch of blue circles. So here's all those white circles. You can't really see them, but you'll be able to see it once it's on top of the photo. Okay, there's my white ones, and then some blue ones sitting back behind it. So that was a pretty simple piece to put together. Let's see, then I created, let's go look at the rocket real quick. There's the rocket. Again, there's the body of the rocket. It's white, so you can't see it. And again, this one is just created with simple shapes. This was an oval. I overlaid another. I stretched it a little bit, overlaid a piece right here to clip that off. The fins are sitting behind a couple circles. Really pretty straightforward rocket right there. And my last piece was the trail that leads up to it. And again, pretty simple shape. Started off with a couple curves, joined them, gave it a stroke and a fill. And that's really all there is to that one. Okay, so you could go create those in Illustrator. I just did it a few minutes ago. But using simple shapes, I came up with something pretty straightforward. So let's go back over to Photoshop now. Now the main thing I have to do here is just pay attention to my layers. So my clouds go on top of my background, but they're going to go underneath the mountain so that they can tuck behind. Okay, so I can always rearrange my layers later, but I might as well try and get them right the first time. So I'm going to select the background, and I'm going to come up to File, and I'm going to go down to Place. And I can either do a Place Embedded or a Place Linked. Embedded will put the Illustrator artwork, save it in my Photoshop file. Linked will keep it linked to the external ones. The advantage being if I wanted to go make an edit to it and then save it in Illustrator, it would update the one here. However, if I go with the linked one, I have to make sure those Illustrator files travel with my Photoshop file when I move it anywhere. I'm going to go with linked just in case I want to make changes to the Illustrator files. So place linked. And let's start with clouds.ai, and I'm going to do a place. Okay, see it's opening it as a smart object, so I'm going to say okay. There it is. And so I can go ahead and resize it. This is vector, so I can make it any size I want. And I was going to put it over this vicinity, so I can kind of size it and get it placed how I want it. That's about what I want. And I'm going to hit return to accept that. Okay, let's see my next one. I'm going to put the lines that run up to it. And that's going to go behind the cloud. So again, I'm going to click on background here to put it on top of that. I'm going to come do a place linked. Let's see, I named that one trail. That's right, trail.ai, place. Okay, there's my smart object. Again, I'm going to size it and kind of move it into place. Go something like that. And I hit return last time. You can do return, or there's a checkbox up here. You can use either one. Okay, my final one is my rocket, and it's going to sit on top of this. So I'm going to stay on the trail layer, file, place linked. Let's see, there's my rocket. Place that. Okay. And let's check his size. I think his size is pretty good. Maybe make him a tiny bit bigger. There we go. Return. And there we go. So there's my composition. You can see all of my layers over here. And I've got everything put together here. It is possible to place bitmap images into Illustrator. It's a very similar process. I kind of prefer going this way and putting my vector into Photoshop because with it in Photoshop, I can keep an eye on my pixel artwork and keep in mind whether or not I'm resizing it, and I don't want to mess with the resolution of that. So I kind of like moving it this direction. So I'm going to go do a save real quick, and then I think I am all done. So pretty straightforward approach to combine them, but I wanted to walk you through that real quick.